You're tagged, dude.
It says Doug Barnes, Monty, and Carlos.
What a chop.
Oh, look at that.
There it is.
There it is. There's the one. Patience. Go ahead. Say
patience.
Whatever you're going
to
say,
Monty. Oh, no. I'll say it.
Okay. Well, oh, my. This is okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And hold on a second. I got to get
something.
My screen is like.
It says
totally.
I'm supposed to say something.
Uh-oh. No.
Just share it.
No, no. Wait. We got to get. I can't. I'm blacked out. Okay, there we go.
Oh, we're on.
Oh, my gosh.
We used to play that song.
Yeah. I hope we're live. I think, oh, Doug Barnes. Ruben Gonzalez is on already.
Man, they're already hopping on.
There you go. Look at that.
Oh, my gosh.
Hop on. We were talking about Iggy Pop.
Quick, play something.
Iggy Pop and Peanut Butter. I thought we could convince Doug to do Nutella.
Okay, let's play. Let's rock and roll. Let's get one out of the ropes here. So
wait a minute. I think
welcome, everybody.
Like that,
welcome to 22.
22 is on.
I think Kevin Craig's on there, and so Kevin, you need to work on this song when you show up and do this with it.
Yeah, right on.
Do this.
Hey, Carlos is on the remote. Yeah, Carlos, go for it.
Oh man, RC, no Carlos. Woo!
Tom up.
Way to go, fellas.
Yeah, sounded great. How y'all doing? How we doing?
Good
Carlos.
Evening.
Carlos, you back? Hey, Carlos did the work. I didn't have to do the work for him.
Yep, you're welcome.
You're welcome. How you doing, Carlos?
Doing all right. How you guys doing?
Good. What's going on? Let's start with Carlos tonight. We always start with us. Let's start with Carlos.
Yes.
Carlos, how was your week?
This is like therapy session right here.
We'll bring a couch.
My week's been good.
Yeah, what did you do? Anything thrilling? I noticed that you did more posts than anybody I know on Facebook, by the way.
Oh, man, it's, you know.
Carlos had to do his story. I'm like, what the hell again? What's up with Carlos, man? He's got so many things going.
I went to Disneyland again.
Nice.
On Tuesday.
Yeah, yeah.
And then went to see the Angel game again on Wednesday.
You saw the walk-off.
That was on Sunday. Sunday was good.
I think that's the last game they're going to win this season.
Wednesday was a disaster. It was a 9-1 Detroit.
Yeah, 91?
Yeah.
But I got to see a Mike Trout home run, so that's, you know.
So what happened on the walk-off? When was that? What night was
that? That was Sunday. Sunday, 1 o'clock game.
Were you there at the game?
I watched Matt Theis. He's the guy they brought up to play third base.
Okay.
He's a lefty. He's actually a really good hitter.
Yeah, yeah.
He's developing.
Yeah. He hit a two-run shot on the second and then home run to win the game.
Wow, right on. Did the crowd just go absolutely ape?
Well, there was nobody there on Sunday.
Oh, no one there in the stands. You guys got front row then.
It was hot.
Yeah.
And everyone was in the shade.
Carlos gave it a golf clap.
Yeah.
He's a Dodger fan.
How much those tickets cost you?
A lot of money.
Well. Oh, no. Monty, how was your – you went, right?
No. No, we did not go, and I'm glad we didn't because they lost.
There's some team support right there.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, no, we had something else going on, but I heard later on that the bullpen came in and just torched and ignited everything.
They should just, once the starter runs out of gas, they should just go, all right, let's just play defense now and not even pitch. Just let the guys throw it up.
Slow
and hit
pitch.
It.
Yeah, just like.
No, over the line. Just
a bunch of fire starters in the bullpen.
So now where are we at standing wise for the Angels?
They had a chance at the wild card.
Mathematically eliminated in June.
Are you serious?
I wasn't in June, but they're not going to go anywhere.
They're not going to go anywhere this year.
How about
the Dodgers? How are the Dodgers doing?
They're doing good.
The best in baseball.
Yeah. Are they really?
Yes.
Wow.
One of the best teams in baseball right now. So.
Does that hurt your feelings a little bit there, Montrose?
No, not at
all. You like the Dodgers?
I don't understand why there's.
If they're in it, I'll root for them. I can't claim to be a Dodgers fan because
I don't understand
been.
Why right. You can't have a National League team and an American League team. And we're Southern California. Why can't you like both?
Well, I worked with dudes that are homers that like both teams.
Yeah.
Guys like, no, man, I go root for the Dodgers. I root for the Angels. So I don't know.
Now, is your amp off?
Yes.
Are we standby?
Yep.
Beautiful. I don't know. I hate being a bandwagoner, but whoever's in the World Series and winning the most games, I'm in, no, baby.
You buy the hat?
I've got the Velcro hat that I put different patches on every day, you know. What's up with that? Yeah, so good. You went to Andrew game. That was good. How about you, Doug? How was your weekie, buddy?
You know, I can't tell when there's a weekend because I'm off every day, so.
Well, I mean, let's just.
I didn't even know today's August. I'm looking for the groundhog to come out and see a shadow still.
Yeah, exactly.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. What is your house almost done now?
No, we're getting closer. We're just about to do the what's that stuff they put on the outside of the stucco?
I would say stucco.
Yeah, if they're still using that.
Yeah,
I thought maybe we could get a wrap, like a Team Swollen wrap on.
Oh,
the
yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Just wrap houses from now on. That'd be a great idea.
Yeah.
House wrap.
Why aren't they doing that?
I don't know. They should. I think it'd be a good
idea. Copyright. Copyright.
Yeah, copyright strike. Oh,
so
wrapping.
So you're saying you can go back to walking around with your robo then?
Oh,
wow.
Yeah.
Harvey.
Yeah, I think he stands around like... what's that guy, the Playboy Mansion guy? What was him?
Hugh Hefner.
Hugh Hefner, yeah, with your robe on, smoking jacket on.
Yeah, no. No robe.
No robe, no smoking.
Just boxers.
Just socks.
Yeah. Just boxers.
Yeah. Black
the
socks.
Neighbors are like, okay, Doug Barnes is about to leave our neighborhood.
Socks and sandals.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, there's a little cute story about you playing one night in a neighbor encounter. You were jamming really loud.
Oh, yeah.
What happened?
The guy that lived next door to us, he worked for the phone company, and he was up nights. His shift, he managed the shift from his house.
Right.
So he's always up all night, and it's like, I don't know, midnight or better. And I've got music on loud, playing along to CDs or whatever. Just everything is moving some air, right?
Right.
Drying my hair in front of the amp. And the song stops. And this is, I had asked the guy next door, I said, hey, you know, do you ever hear me playing in the middle of the night? He's like, nah, I don't hear nothing. You're good. So I continued. He moved, and a mom and her daughter, the daughter's like, I don't know, 16 maybe, they move in next door. And so I'm on the same program. I've not heard anything from anybody, and I'm just blazing one night. And the CD gets in between songs. And so there's a pause, and I hear ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, knock, 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 knock. And I'm like, wow, what was that? So I go to the door in my robe.
His pants.
In his socks.
I go to the door, and I open
the
door.
It's just the guitar covering him.
And it's the girl in her pajamas with a jacket on, and she just looks like Bill the Cat.
Can I come in?
you remember Bill the Cat from Bloom County? It was just like, and she's just like fried looking, and she's going like this. And I go, too loud? She just goes.
Like, what time was it?
I don't know. It's after midnight.
Oh man,
JJ Cale.
Yeah.
But, wow. But yeah, that was
that's hilarious.
So I didn't play loud for them anymore. I just.
I think the better of the story is, like Carlos said, you should have said, "Well, I went in. I only had my socks on and my guitar. That was it. And I'm working it."
Right? He went Blink 182 for.
There's kids.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Generation.
Yeah, yeah.
There's kids that watch this.
I know there is. Monty, how about you? How was your week, buddy? How was work and all that? Good.
Oh, we're good. Yeah, we're good. My son's getting married Saturday.
Oh,
so.
Oh, nice.
Oh wow. So you're going to be a grandpa again sometime, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
Right on, right on.
There'll be more coming, more coming.
Wow, right on. So how long have they been dating? How long have they been
together?
Over
2 years.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, they've been dating over 2 years, so it's I think time. It's time he closes the deal.
Right, and where are they getting married at?
Santa Barbara.
Oh, right on.
Dougie's coming up Saturday to do sound.
Wow, Douglas Barnes. Is that a present for your buddy?
If traffic permits.
Yeah.
Don't say that.
Don't
man.
Say
if
that.
If he's watching, he's... What?
Are you going to be the DJ? Are you going to talk in between?
Oh, no, no, no.
No, no?
Nah, it's no. Low-keyed. It's going to be just he's going to plug a phone
just,
in.
Yeah, gotcha.
I'm not even going to like be part of the wedding thing at all. I'm just going to be doing the sound, so I'll just be there with my robe and
no
my
band,
socks.
Just DJ? Is
no,
that what
he's
you're
just
talking about?
He's going to queue up collective works of Bette Midler. And we're going to rock to that.
The Leo Sayer greatest hits. And
I'm just
going to
go. There's where the plug is. I'll see you guys in a couple of hours.
He's right. There for the fish.
Right, right. How do you guys, you know, I was thinking... You know, doing the work this week, and you know,
yeah, how was your week, brother?
Oh, brother, it was crazy. Mm-hmm. Anyways, the new joint that I work, and I'm not going to mention the joint I work, but most of you probably already know. But my gosh, I mean, it is so amazing to watch young kids work. They are so awful.
So you work
and they put
In-N-Out?
Them in charge. They darn near close. Thanks, Carlos. Darn near close. The hat hurts though. I have it on. Yeah. It's truly amazing to, you know, because I'm just go-getter. You know, I just get in there, put my head down, and just
Punk
go crazy.
Work.
And I think
I've
I overwork. Them. I think I'm overdoing it there. Let's just put it that way. And it's just, it's amazing to watch that they put these kids in charge of major deals, and they just can't handle it. They just can't. They don't have it. Have you ever ran into that before?
There is a certain businesses have a culture. So I got a guy that went from working at a Ford dealer where... You turn and burn because you're getting paid by the flagged hour. So if you get 8 hours to do a job, you get it done in six, you're styling.
You're golden,
because you just got paid 8 hours. So you can get, you know, you can make 16 hours in a day. You know, you just rock and roll. You're making a lot of money.
Right.
So he takes a job at the County of Orange, and he's over there tearing into an engine, you know, getting, and these guys come over and go, hey, slow down. We're paid by the hour here. You don't get, you know, there's no hurry. That work will be here tomorrow. And he's just like, what's your ethic? You know, where's your work ethic? Right. And I'm thinking, where's my tax dollar being spent properly?
Right.
I was a little put off by that.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, is that the way? Is it that easy to have government waste all through that? But it was the culture. I mean, they've been nurturing that county business that way.
Yeah, and I just wonder why, you know, when you're interviewing for positions and you're putting these kids in as managers, it's just unbelievable because they are absolutely making the wrong decisions for things that should be made.
Yeah,
with experience.
Well,
let's put it that way.
In that situation, where you've got to have a template for what everybody's supposed to be doing and how they do it.
Yeah, correct.
Standard.
And train them that way.
Yeah.
And if you let them make some decisions, then they're just Oh, just do whatever.
Just whatever. Yeah, it's just crazy. So that's probably the hardest part of the whole thing. It's getting to be able to work with these kids. And, you know, I'm just, I think my kid's like, yeah, I think you're overthinking it. Just go ahead and go to work, get your paycheck, get out of there. That's your whole, you know, a smart little kid there. That's Zach for you. But, I mean, really, it's just so frustrating sometimes working with kids. It's just like, oh, my God, just want to pull my hair out. But I shouldn't take it like that, you know. But that's the only reason that, the only thing that's kind of a bummer about that whole thing is just no work ethic in anybody. Well, there's, you know,
different mentality.
Totally. Yeah.
It's
totally.
Different mentality.
For a lot of them, if that's their first job, they don't know anything else.
Right.
You know,
they're
developing their own work ethic and quality.
What can I get out of during this day? What do I not have to do but to get
right? Yeah.
Right. And there's people standing around. There's people standing around, and then the people that are supposed to be doing something are in the break room, you know, eating burritos.
In contrast, you guys remember the movie Big? You remember when he sits down, and Tank starts banging out the work, and Levitz leans over and goes, "Hey,
yeah,
slow down."
Yeah, right.
What? You know, he's just there to work.
Yeah, yeah.
Levitz, you know, you're going too fast. You're gonna make us look bad.
Yeah.
And he goes, "The job sucks, but the benefits are great." He goes, "Ginger over there, all you gotta do is say hi, and she's yours." I gotta say it. It's not a bit. It happened in the movie. He goes. She'll
Doug wrap. Doug still gave him a look like, "What the hell are you saying?"
He goes, "She'll wrap her legs around you and have you screaming for mercy." And then Hanks goes, "I'll stay away from her then."
Yeah. Great movie.
We just got bumped up to PG.
Yeah, PG. Sorry, PG-13.
No, it is Carlos, after 7:30.
I know. How are we looking over there, brother?
Hey, we got a lot of people joining
dark.
In.
We got a lot of people?
We got Kimberly Myers, Sammy Burke.
Sammy Burke. How you doing, Sammy Burke?
Eric Patrick Arian. He says, "Play some Led Zeppelin."
Oh,
that's like the fifth Led Zeppelin.
That's my new nephew, Kona's nephew.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, he plays guitar.
Oh,
we got John Rayburn.
Rayburn's always there. Mr. Pink Floyd.
Eric also says, "Play some trash metal."
Trash metal. What do we know?
Kevin
that's
Craig.
That's what we play.
Yeah, yeah.
What's Kevin say?
It's everything we play.
Kevin doesn't say. He's just joining in. Clapping.
Stop playing.
Yeah, Kevin, any requests? Yeah, stop playing.
Yeah,
stop.
Yeah.
Stop.
So it was a good week. We had Doug and I did sound at the...
We had back-to-backers, dude. Regal Beagle.
God, I couldn't even think of it. I'm so out of it. Regal Beagle. And we had some decent bands there.
Yes, we did.
We did, right? Talk to me about that, Doug. Go ahead. Fill me in on the bands that we had. We had Hurricane.
The next night.
The Hurricanes.
Yeah.
You know, I just looked at it earlier.
Was that band, the second band? All female singers, by the way, female vocalists. Do we say singers or vocalists? How come you say a vocalist for one thing, singer in another? Monty?
I think vocal stylings, they're not necessarily, they don't have to be a really good singer. They're just a vocalist.
And I think it's the same difference.
I think it's the same
difference.
Am I a guitar player or a guitarist?
That was a good one, though.
So if you said on Match Game, you said vocalist, and somebody up on the panel said singer, you would ding it, right?
Ding.
I got you. All right. I got you. Yeah, so it was interesting. The Hurricanes, excuse me, they had a drummer, Ross. And Ross is from a band called Devang, and they play at...
they played the next night. Someplace.
They played the next night, I think, at the OC Fair, and they were decent. I mean, he sang some songs, and they had, you know, all covers. I don't think they did any originals. Did they do any originals?
Don't remember.
Yeah, and the second band, great female singer. I thought she was good, and they had originals, and they were good. I can't remember the last band that played. Oh, it was, I can't remember the last band that played. But we've done sound for them before. At least two of them we've done sound for before at Fitzgerald's years ago. But that was how that went down. But did you like any of the bands? Give me your honest opinion. Be honest.
So Saturday night.
Oh, no.
So Saturday. Yeah, we got a little story.
Moving on.
We got to get. Oh, dude.
What?
The chick that cussed us out that one day.
She was back.
She was mellow.
What?
I was talking to Kona out in the parking lot before the first band started up, and she walked by, and she goes, "Hi." And she kept going.
Whoa.
And so I talked to Bobby. He goes, "Yeah, she's probably on her meds or something. She's really happy today."
Wow.
Yeah, she was. Like
she didn't cuss you out like
no,
did
like
for
Doug
us.
Almost like got cussed out after the
no
second band.
Wasn't even close.
What happened? Okay, talk to me. So what happened Saturday? What was the events? Where'd you guys do? Bobby V's?
Yes, sir.
Oh, I went to Bobby V's.
Yes, you did.
The parking lot was full, and I just went in. I turned around, went out, and then I was gone. That was it.
That's because there's a music scene, people at Bobby V's in Anaheim, Euclid, and Catella. There's a music scene happening. Get down there now.
At Bobby
V's.
And get down there early to get parking on the lot.
Yeah, I thought Bobby V was going to come down, and you just gave him a great promotion. So what happened?
No, he's coming. I talked to him Saturday.
All right.
He goes, yeah, I just got to get a night. I can get down.
I got you. Right on. What happened? What was the bands that played, and what went down? You guys want to talk about it, or what? Is it one of those things that's hard to talk about?
Well, Doug asserted his fatherly...
No, it was like you got four bands to go. And first band's on Ogre Ballet, right?
Ogre Ballet.
Starting just a little bit after 8.
Got it.
Supposed to be done at 8:45. They're done at 8:45. They're off the stage in 5 minutes.
5 minutes it took them.
I want to hug those guys.
Exactly. They're great.
I want to hug them. Yeah.
So
Ogre Ballet, way to go, brothers.
So we just had a little trouble with the next band.
Get on that mic.
Getting started up. And the time just went, you know. And so it's, I gave a little bit of starting late time, a little bit of love there. And then it was, the singer was late getting there. They played without the singer for a while. And then he came by. And was doing a couple songs, and I said, you guys got time for 2 more songs. And so they do 2 more songs, and then they go, we got 1 more song, and they started going. Now, if they'd have said to me, hey, we got 1 more, can we go? Because I'm already got, you know, the other band, the third band is already going, hey, how are we on time? What do we got people coming.
Right,
you know,
right.
You got slots, they give you a slot, and your people come for that slot.
And you have 4 bands.
And we got 4 bands. And so I shut it down because they just started into the next song.
Oh, no.
And that's the first time I've had to do that.
Doug, shut it down.
You know, sometimes you got to, if you just ask me, I'm good, you know. They go,
Spider.
Hey, we got another one. And as long as it's not, I've told the band 1 more song, and they go into some medley of 3 songs or something, and it's 10 minutes. And it's like, that's,
they go
you
into
can't
the,
do that.
The Necromancer by Rush.
Yeah, bands cannot wag the dog.
Were they, what went down after you turned them off? I don't even want to know.
Fisticuffs City.
No, turned into a country bar fight.
No, I went out and talked to Jackie, and then he came back in, and that was it.
Let's go outside.
But I was like, the bands, they don't get to wag the dog.
Whoa.
Oh. Whoa!
That's a bumper sticker and
a Doug.
And a T-shirt.
And a T-shirt. So they were mad. Let's just put it that way.
But you know what Doug cut him off to? What song?
What was it?
Cold Gin.
Oh, why? Okay, now I'm mad.
Live Kiss.
Now I'm mad.
That's what I brought up in the house.
Oh, you brought out.
I brought
live,
this down.
Live
Kiss
Cold
Alive
Gin.
One. Cold Gin.
I love it. Okay, you brought that up. I thought you were getting ready to play that.
No.
Okay,
but I can tell you that if it had gone any way but the way that it went, we were just going to pack up and go. I mean, the bands do not get to run.
I walked out and talked to Jackie, and I just said, "Hey, Jackie, just letting you know, they don't direct us." And she just listened. She didn't say anything. She just goes, "Oh, okay." You know, we're doing sound for not a lot of money, so you're not gonna. If there's 4 bands, you ain't directing us tonight.
Right, right.
We're gonna get the other 2 bands on because
and the band that follows them, if they see that, then they're gonna do that. And it's just like, no, there's a standard, and you're here to play.
Then it's bloody
anarchy.
We
get that. We're gonna give you the best sound that we can.
And how many songs did they get in before you shut them down?
Well, no, they got in a set.
Yeah.
It's just their lead singer, the dude. He missed 3/4 of the set. It's a Saturday. How do you miss your set?
Oh, he didn't. He wasn't even on stage.
He wasn't there. He didn't show up until 2 songs left.
What? Who sang?
The guitar player.
The guitar. I think it's father and son team. I think the guitarist is the dad.
Maybe.
And yeah, I think it's. And then mom came up and bent Doug's ear a little bit.
Oh no!
She wanted to know why you know.
Doug went all Captain Phillips.
So did all the bands get on? Third band went on okay. Fourth
band
went okay.
And the cool thing was I let the third band play as long as they wanted.
Oh my gosh!
Not really.
No, he didn't.
Angry.
They only had 30
angry sound guys. You'll never be back.
The fourth band ended up going. They were just like a 30-minute set.
Well, Carlos, let me know who's playing. We're gonna play a song. Let's do Cotton of Crossfire.
Tom Guzzo just joined. Michelle Lopez. But you guys should play another song.
Oh, Guzzo. Guzzo, I was going to ask Guzzo. Because Guzzo, here's the good thing about Guzzo. Guzzo was my manager at Home Depot when I worked at Depot. Great manager, well, night manager. He had it down. He knew, he put the right guys in charge, and he put the guys that need to be on the floor. And I was like so happy for how he ran that show. You know what I mean? He knew what to do.
Well, yeah, because then you get everybody working like that, and then he can go take a nap for
that's
hours.
Exactly what he did. Right, no! Guzzo? Right, no! Guzzo? Guzzo, hit me up, man.
That's hilarious.
No, but caught. Tom
does he
good.
Still work there?
No, he's done.
Oh, good. Okay.
But
there goes your
they caught him napping.
Yeah, there goes your 401k.
Yeah, something went down with Guzzo. I'm not sure yet, but I'm sure it was caught napping.
Caught him napping.
That's like the security guy out here.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, he hangs halfway outside his door. Yeah, but Guzzo's a good one for that. Okay, so let's do some UFO for our friends.
I want to make sure all six of my amps are up and running. Hang on just a second.
We're gonna do this song for the band, the second band called Lights Out. I'm just kidding.
Tom Guzzo just put napping Z's.
Channel your Phil Mogg right now.
Yeah, Phil Mogg. I'm gonna channel.
Rock on,
Phil
guys.
Mogg. Okay, kids, we're gonna play some rock and roll, right? Right?
Right. We'll be right back.
That sounded good.
Thanks.
Carlos, where are you? Back? Did you shut yourself off and back on again?
I gave myself a break.
Was
that a 15-minute break? I guess it depends on the guitar solo.
It depends on the song.
The song and how long it takes.
So, hey, guys.
Uh-oh, here we go. Know,
the other guy's wives. No.
Oh, my gosh.
They said it was cool.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
Monday, Colin and I are out for a jog. We usually go try to go Monday, Wednesday,
oh,
Friday.
Here we go.
Get some exercise in. So we're jogging, and I've always been told, guys, check me on this, rules of the road. If you're jogging, you jog into traffic so you can see who's coming at you. You don't jog with traffic because you'll get run over.
Yeah.
True.
Okay.
Isn't that with bicycling, too?
Okay.
No.
I got a problem with cyclists around town.
Oh.
I've discovered these guys think they own the road.
They do.
They do own the road?
No, I'm just joking.
Okay. I thought I was missing something. But anyway, so we go down by this park by the house, and I'm cruising. I'm in the bike lane. But cyclist coming at me, I'm in the gutter. I'm in the white stripe. Like, hey, dude, you got, you know, at least 3-4 feet. You're good.
And if there's no bike lane, he's okay in traffic because he's riding with traffic.
And there was no cars around at all because it's dead over there.
What time of night was this? Or
no, this was in the afternoon. Dude.
Oh, right on.
This is like quarter to four in the afternoon.
Right, right.
So I'm in the gutter running. He comes towards me and I my hand up like, hey, bro, what's up? You're like, hey. He goes. Other side yells at me, and so quickest thing response was,
oh no,
I just go, bite me, as he cruised by,
right? Oh,
and
no.
I started thinking, and I go, you're wrong, yelled back at him again.
You start fighting with the guy in the middle.
Come on brother, bring those tight pants back here, bro.
Oh no,
let's rumble. But it's like the guy, and I talked to a dude at work, the same thing. He lives out in Redlands, and he said There's a cyclist group out there, and that's cool. Hey, God bless them that they work out and have bikes to ride.
Yeah.
But he said you'll be cruising down the road,
right?
And they'll dirty dog you. You know, they'll like, what are you doing?
Oh, man? Yeah, yeah.
Mad dog you.
Yeah.
And so he gets as close as he can to them in the bike.
Oh no.
He gets. But it's like, you know, some of them are really rude.
Did
Most
you say
of
that guy's name before? In case something goes down, I think he said his name.
I want to know why they're not single file.
Well, here's the deal. Here's the kicker. He's telling me
down by the river.
He's telling
in a van.
Me to get to the right side. You know, get over. You're on the wrong side.
Yeah.
As he blows through stop signs.
Right.
Okay. He's a vehicle.
Right.
If he's on the bike,
no, he's
got to
do the road.
Same rules.
Same rules.
And they just blow through stop signs. They don't care. Yeah. You know. So you know what, cyclists, be kind here, fellow joggers.
My gig on that is when you see these cats, and some of them shouldn't be wearing those tight things. You know what I mean? Some of them look like Pillsbury Doughboys stuck in that thing, and it's like, really, I don't want to see that. And then I don't want to see other things.
It's protection for when they go down.
Is that what that's for?
Yeah, so that they don't get their skin ripped up or whatever. If you're wearing pants, like loose pants, it'll grab and
yeah, but no,
I heard it was aerodynamic
but the
too.
They only go down to the top of the knee.
Well, I know they're not worried about skinning up their legs. They don't want their hips and whatnot.
And fell
ever into bike riding?
Bits and pieces.
No.
Did you have a bike when you were younger, like a 10-speed Bill Schwinn?
I had a Stingray.
You had a Stingray.
Stingray. Banana seat.
Then I got a.
banana seat.
Yeah.
You know, it was a banana seat.
Dude.
So yeah.
They were stock with banana seats.
When I got my first Schwinn, we went to Bell Schwinn. I got it blue. You remember the blue Stingray?
Oh, yeah.
It was beautiful. You know, they had the little
mini H.
The mini H and the streamers hanging off the thing.
Because the original ones had like more of a V. They're probably all around the team swollen. Those bars
everywhere.
The original ones kind of went out.
There you go, Tard.
That's right. Yeah, like ape hangers kind of thing. Yeah,
they weren't that tall, but they were out more.
Yeah.
And then you got the mini H ones.
That's right. Those were cool. Those were on, I think, the one with the shifter, whatever, the lemon peeler, I think. Those are the ones that.
Orange crate, lemon peeler.
Orange crate, yeah.
Picker,
oh, dude,
picker.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have every single. If you guys want to go to Team Swollen and grab a Schwinn, have at it. Todd loaned you one. You can drive it around. You have to pump up the tires.
Right, I've got
and hopefully
one.
They don't crumble on you.
I've got one, but I think it was. I thought they were reissuing them.
Right.
And I didn't know they were making them in China, and I bought one anyway.
Right.
So it's hanging in my garage, and I think I'm going to take it over and drop it off. Todd, if you're on tonight, you want my purple Chinese Stingray.
He'll take it. Yeah, he'll take it. Don't ever sell it. The beauty about Todd is everybody drops off their collectibles. You know why?
Because he's
they'll
a collector.
Be there.
Yeah.
sell them.
You get to go back and visit your stuff.
That's
kind of cool. It's like giving it to the Smithsonian. It's the Toddsonian.
It's the Toddsonian.
Okay, who here is?
Oh my gosh, it's hilarious.
Has hit like a curb or the back of a car and met with your gooseneck.
Oh man. Yeah.
So as I'd ridden through mud and my tires were now the mud's dried, and I'm riding along and I noticed that if I dragged my foot on the tire, it would smoke off. The dirt would dust off and it looked like smoke.
No.
So I get riding along and I'm looking back like this and dragging my foot on the tire, and I ride a little bit farther, and then I do it some more, and I'm looking back, and it's right into a parked car.
Oh, no.
Right up on the truck.
Not serious?
No, it wasn't.
It wasn't crazy.
It wasn't painful. It was muy embarrassing, though.
Did you look around and then get back up?
No, I didn't
look. Did you look around?
Because if you look, they can recognize you. Yeah. So I just jumped on it and just boogied.
Oh my God.
But that was back when they made real bumpers.
Oh, the car was steel.
It didn't
fold on you.
It
if
didn't
you looked
move.
At them.
Yeah.
They were barely doing aluminum beer cans at that point before they were putting aluminum on anything.
Yeah, I remember that bike I had, and my dad, you know, I was like begging him every day. Hey, I need, all my friends had the Schwinn, and I wanted to be part of the gang, right? So we go down and we get the Schwinn for me, and man, that thing was like glowing. It was so awesome. And the ice cream truck comes down the street, and I want an ice cream. And guess where I put the bike? In front of the ice cream truck.
Nice.
I get my ice cream, we're on the other side, and all we hear is Crunchola. It was done, dude.
There was no saving it, huh?
No saving it. My dad just looked at me and said, well, you can take a look at it over in the corner.
Kevin,
I was so bummed, yeah.
Kevin Craig says that there was a sweet spot on the banana seat where you can ride a wheelie.
That's correct.
Forever.
Yes.
Yeah. The banana seats are great.
I did hold the neighborhood record for a wheelie on my Stingray with the banana seat.
Yeah.
And hitting parked cars.
One-handed, Doug. Doug, one-handed peace sign?
No. I was too busy. Oh. It was a long ride, and you were going pretty fast at the end of
the
ride.
Brookshire? We used to take it.
Way around and then ended up on Brookshire.
We would take it over to Peralta and wet the sidewalks at Peralta and do speedway, you know, on those things. Because they had the slicks on the back, you know.
Right.
I mean, who was thinking of putting a slick on a bike for a kid?
It's supposed to look like a drag racing slick was the point.
Oh.
And so that's why there was no tread on it. But we'd do that on the street corner down the street from our house.
Oh, yeah.
No water. You just go and lay the bike down, and it'd slide for you.
Yeah.
And so we were making hot shoes and all this stuff. And then we're doing it in the backyard. We had a pretty good-sized backyard.
Well, so what happened to McConnell? He just took it literally and, like, put an engine in it? Because it's basically just a bike with an engine in it, right?
Well, I don't speedway know. Those things, you get a look at those speedway bikes up close, and they're a purpose bike. You don't go riding those things any place but right there and really really fast and really scary.
Yeah, real scary.
I don't know how those guys do
that. Yeah. What you got over there, Carlos? Talk to me.
Well, Tom Guzzo posted up a picture, and it says this one's for Charles.
Oh, no. What is it?
And it's a picture of Adam Rich and Gene Simmons.
Oh, no.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
I know
about?
What you're talking about, yeah.
It says, Adam Rich is one of the most popular young stars on TV today.
It was eight is enough, right?
Yeah, eight is enough. Why would Gene Simmons be with that? It's kind
of
creepy.
And whenever he goes out in public, he's surrounded by fans. Recently, he met Gene Simmons of Kiss, just in case you didn't know what Gene Simmons it was.
There's only one Gene Simmons.
And I know. And
there
then it says.
Two. There was an actress.
That's right. Gene Simmons. Yeah.
And they exchange autographs. Even stars have favorite stars just like you.
Oh, wow. That's good. Thank you, Guzzo.
Mr. Guzzo.
That.
That's nice.
Mr. Guzzo.
What a sentimental guy.
That reeks of late 70s.
That's total late 70s. Yeah. Gene Simmons is an amazing guy. I mean, I can't believe he's still up there rock and rolling, and he's still giving it his all. I mean, even though they're up there, I just watched the concert. It was overseas of the last thing. I could care about the drummer and the other guitarists. I don't even know who they are, but I'm not going to do that. But Gene and Paul, for as much as you want to give them crap, you know, for lip singing or whatever it is, the guy's amazing. Those two guys are just still up there doing
entertainers.
It. Entertaining to the 10th power.
Big time.
Still spitting the blood. Still, you know, all the stuff he's doing, it's just crazy.
But here's the question. when they go into the Hall of Fame?
Yeah.
Are they going to use his outfit from now, the extra large one, or the smaller one from 75 tour?
I think they should accept the award Dressed to Kill.
Oh, yeah. Put the suits on. Oh, yeah.
He's like,
yeah. He was like this.
Yeah. Did I tell you when I went to New York, I looked for that street corner. I couldn't find it. I looked on the maps. I was looking everywhere.
I had a buddy that went to New York, and he and his son went to all the mafia hit areas.
Oh, see, that would have been cool, too.
Well, no, I'm thinking that there's got to be somebody that gives you the KISS tour areas.
I looked for it, and I asked around. 42nd Street, I think what it is. I just could never find it or get to that area to where it was. But that would have been cool to see that, you know, where that area is. But it's amazing to watch those two guys just get it together and still do it, you know. Yeah. And that being said, for... Even the Rolling Stone cats, man, those guys are still up there.
Oh, my gosh.
How old is those guys? I mean, what's the drummer's?
Charlie Watts.
That guy's got to be 105. He's got to be 110. Yeah, but he's up there still drumming. Yeah, still giving it his all.
Keith Richards.
Well, here's a Peter Frampton's got this neuromuscular disorder, the same one that I've got.
Yeah.
And there was an article that he was talking about. The problems that he's going to have, and he's like, I don't want to play so long till I played too long, and I don't play at my best for the fans. He's concerned about playing a show and people being disappointed.
Stand by.
And so he's just like...
Stand by.
What?
Stand by. Is it on standby?
Yeah.
Oh, why is this so noisy right
it's
now?
It's this one.
Oh, it's that one. Okay, go ahead.
I'll turn it on later.
It's all right. You were talking so soft, and I could hear it.
Okay, well, anyway, so Peter Frampton says he's going to do a farewell tour. I wasn't getting emotional yet.
When was he getting emotional?
It was getting there.
Thank you. I broke up the monotony on that.
He talked with his agent or whoever, tour guy, and said, let's do one farewell tour so that I know I'm playing at a level that I want to represent.
Right.
And so with that kind of an ethic, there's got to be some bands out there that should have hung it up a while ago. And it's not that they don't have something that's going to cause their fingers not to work, but it's, you know, they're old and they're...
Yeah, I think there's a few of them that should have done it without the original members. You know, a lot of the guys go on the road with, like, Rat. I don't think Rat. There's two Rats, right?
Well,
they're all different.
Robin Crosby, he died.
Yeah. So it's like heroin. It's a tribute band for the most part. If you, how can you still call it what it is if it's not?
Steve Sose asked me. Well, I went to see Blue Oyster Cult and Deep Purple a couple years ago.
Okay.
He goes, so at what point is it a tribute band?
Right.
You don't have the original members.
I agree with that, you know. I mean, Deep Purple is a great example of that. I mean, you know, Blackmore.
I think Steve Morse has been in the band longer than Blackmore ever was.
And Blackmore and Gillan will never get together.
You know, here's what we should do. We should have the death cage match in wrestling or boxing or whatever. You get Phil Mogg and Ian Gillan on one side and Michael Schenker and Richie Blackmore
just
on the other.
Go at it.
And tag team. Just have them brawling.
Speaking of UFO, they're coming over to the Grove. Did you guys want to go watch them?
Coming without Michael Schenker.
Okay. Well,
sorry.
Yeah. I think they got...
That's a tribute band, too,
right? It's Mogg and
who just passed?
Andy Parker. Way's not even with them. Pete Way.
Yeah.
So it's just two dudes. It's the drummer and the singer. That's
and who just passed from UFO?
Paul Raymond.
Raymond, yeah. I mean, that guy was the keyboardist to Rhythm, right?
Well, he was in that classic lineup. There was a dude, Danny Perrinell or something before him.
Right.
But for me, UFO's... is Paul Raymond, Schenker, Pete Way, Phil Mogg, and Andy Parker.
Right.
That classic lineup.
So is it like when you go see him live, is it like the Showtime version of UFO? It's not really rock and roll. It's like, you know,
when
you
had Paul Chapman with them, they played pretty decent. I mean,
Did you see him live?
No.
Never have? Mm-hmm. Only Schenker.
There's your chance.
I caught him in 96. Walk on Water came out, Doug, 95, 96, somewhere around there. Well, anyways, it was that one of those years, 2 years, they came and played a little club in Riverside.
Oh, really?
It was called the Rock House. It's in Cahoots, and then it doesn't exist anymore.
Right.
But they came, and they had, I think, the drummer from AC/DC set in. Andy Parker couldn't make it, but it was everybody else, Raymond.
Was that Slade Cat, or was it Phil Rudd?
I think, well, no, it was their original dude, their original drummer, whoever he What's his name?
I don't even know. I thought it was always Phil Rudd that played for AC/DC. Yeah. It could have been
but
that
But they
guy.
Sounded great. They did Strangers. They just did Strangers.
Yeah. Oh, see, that's the key. I wonder if they're going to do that at the Grove, but I don't know if
it's what everybody wants to hear.
No, I know that.
Well, getting back to Frampton, yeah. He just did an acoustic concert. Mm-hmm. The guy can still play.
Yeah.
I mean, he has chops, but he's going to do that now, I think. He's going to do acoustic versions of his stuff.
So you said you have the same disease, right? So what does this affect on you?
Well, it's a rock star. It affects particular muscles, and it's one side more than another side. So I'm affected on the right side. So the muscles in my arms here that are your deal with your finger strength, your hand strength, and thigh, buttocks, the larger muscles that that keep you balanced. So I'll be walking along, and all of a sudden I'll just veer a little bit, and it'll be harder to get up out of a chair.
So when is it? Like, do we have to replace the guitar player in the band?
It's
tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Everyone, look for podcast number 23.
Number 23.
Send your audition
tapes.
Send your
guitar audition tapes too. We're just going to get every guitarist in here. You guys just all play this song. Learn this song. We're going to just play it and rock and roll it.
Now, Doug, you just adjust.
We'll just put a track on it.
Just grab a slide and play slide.
No, the arthritis is going to get to me before the IBM does. So I'll be.
Eventually not be able to play guitar? Is that the idea? Is that why Peter Frampton is getting done with his deal now? Is that how that works?
Well, it has to do with, on one side or the other, your hand strength.
Right.
And, you measure grip. You got those little devices that you squeeze. It's got a dial on it. So I'm at 60 on this side and 50 on this side. So I don't know what a grown man should have for grip. But
I don't either.
Just be careful. just be careful.
I'm deficient.
Well, I mean,
wow. You know what? You really need to have you need to have a cow at home, and you need to milk daily
oh, no.
to work on your hand strength.
Well, I like the goat's milk better, so we'll get a goat. Yeah. And then
goat milk.
Yeah, it's much
a little more intricate.
What are we looking at, and what time are we at?
We got
this
time.
Is a mellow.
I forgot to say something about the brouhaha at
syndrome
at Bobby V's.
Oh yeah, so what happened to Bobby?
I wanted to say that after the one band went out and we started going, I'm sitting there thinking, well, first Monty came over and posted up, you know, he gave me one of his CBU looks. Like, we're doing crowd control.
Were
right
you
now.
Doing crowd control, Mike?
He went back into the parking lot, put security shirt on.
So
I did.
Well, I want to know what the mom said to you. So can you repeat it?
So anyway, he's standing there posting up, you know, to
are
cover
you
me.
Single?
Because all I'm going to do is fall down and hurt somebody.
Here's my phone number.
If there's like a dog pile, I could like fall into it, but I'm not swinging.
Would you swing?
Anyway,
if you had to swing, would you swing?
You
could do damage, I know you could, but would you swing or would you just lay down and just cover your head?
I drop a hammer. on my way falling down, I'd be tripping over something, and elbow would come down. Monty had my side
there.
Oh,
that's hilarious.
Cheryl was there, and I leaned back to her, and I go, hey, Cheryl, can you do me a favor? Can you see if any of that other band is still hanging around? Because I didn't want to have to get crazy with the other bands just because those guys were off the hook, you know.
Right.
So she goes out and she goes, nah, you're good. They're, you know, none of them around out there anymore. So I breathed a sigh of relief because I didn't need more, you know, I wanted the evening to get back to being mellow.
Yeah.
And so I sent her on a recon. Thank you, Cheryl.
Oh, sure. Nice. Wow. Oh, gosh.
Hey, I haven't seen Cheryl on today. I wanted to hear how Chicago was.
I thought she was.
Chicago.
No. She hasn't signed on today.
Was there another Cheryl?
No.
Saturday in the park. Where did they play at? Where did Chicago? Where were they at?
They were at the Costa Mesa Amphitheater for the fair.
Fair for the fair.
Yeah.
Did anybody go to the fair? You went to the fair. Did you go back to the...
No,
you guys didn't go back? Yeah.
No.
My kid went. He said it's just full of bad food.
It is.
It's bad food. He said it's not even good food. Well, it's just bad.
We had those Swedish potatoes. I think they're, and that was the only good thing.
Right.
I saw people walking around with hamburgers and and corn dogs. I'm like, why would you buy that when they have all this exotic food?
Yeah.
But then I'm like, I wish I would have had a hamburger or a corn dog,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
like freaking A. It's
That's like the street fair. You know, you don't you don't want to grab just a regular burger because they got all these exotic.
Yeah.
Speaking of the street fair this year, Team Swollen will be at the street fair again.
Same corner?
I want to point to like Gazzari. I love Gazzari. Foxy guys. Only have Foxy guys. Yeah, we'll be at the street fair again. They took our corner away from us.
Oh.
You can't imagine how mad Todd is. I mean, you know Todd. He's got to be it's all got to be the same.
What's the whole point of this? So easy to find you. You're there every year.
Oh, my gosh. The guy goes, oh, we emailed you, we messaged you, and they never did, and they gave it to somebody else. So somebody gave a little bit more.
Oh, boy.
But here's the good thing. The good thing is that they're giving us another corner, but it's on the opposite side by the main stage. So it actually, it's going to be okay because it's a good change. We need a change for Team Swollen being in that corner for 5 years.
Yeah.
And we're by the stage, which will be kind of cool. So there'll be more traffic in that area.
Except you'll be sitting there the whole time going,
what?
How come Soul Shaker's not up on that stage?
Yeah, right. You want what kind of shirt? Yeah. So we will be there. I'll let you guys know where we're going to be at Street Fair. And that is at the end of August, the first week of September, if I'm correct on that. It's Labor Day weekend.
It's like the 31st on the Saturday, I think.
Right, yeah, but we do Friday evening from 5 on, and then Saturday and Sunday, and Monday we're off.
Yep.
So we'll let you know about that. You guys come. Whoa! Sorry, guys. What was that?
I don't know.
Was
that the next song coming in?
Wow.
Is that the intro we want?
That's the intro we want. Okay, let's go ahead
play
and
a song.
Chick Magnet.
He's not doing it now.
What happened?
Chick-a-Magno.
The perfect... Wow, that was weird.
You okay?
Man. You all right? I can't wait to watch back and see Doug's face on that one.
I just wanted to know who was...
Is everybody awake out there?
I don't know. Everybody on the other side is going, wait, what was that? We'll be right back.
What is that?
That's round two.
That was F sharp.
Oh. You just broke my record, man.
I just bought it. That's what it
sounded
like. Wow. Oh, my gosh.
So we're going to have our technicians take a look at that.
Yeah, technicians.
Aaron Miller probably just left. Bobby Amodea probably just left. Yeah. Luke probably just left.
Oh, funny. Sorry about that, you guys. We always have some kind of technical issue. You guys don't even know what goes on before we get online.
We have TDs.
Oh, my gosh. It's like this thing to go online.
Is the S silent on that one?
Yeah, yeah. Well, we want to make sure you guys... we want to make sure you guys subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Soul Shaker Garage on YouTube. Yes. Go and click subscribe, and then there's a little bell up on top, and when we have a new broadcast go down, that little bell will cling you, and you guys can come on and watch it.
Sometimes if there's a very loud squeal,
and
you can click that bell
also. I went over to Singapore our last episode, and we were jamming on Singapore.
I'm tired. That was a long
drive. I think it was like more than 100 hours in Singapore.
Oh,
they
man.
Hate us.
We're going to get
they
the invite
yeah.
to play on a sampan.
Yeah, but
we
got a lot of comments, and there was a lot of good stuff. But I can't comment back. Well, yeah. I don't know the little symbols in that, but yeah,
no,
it was
I think
good.
If you do it in English, it'll translate.
Yeah, so just subscribe if you guys. It helps us out. Press a like. We're on Venmo. Is that right,
yes,
Carlos?
Yes, sir.
So we're on Venmo. If you guys want to donate a few dollars to the Soul Shaker Garage,
please donate.
Put it to a
keep
great
lights
source.
On.
Keep the lights on and Doug happy.
Yes, thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah.
It's not really a donation. It's a subscription.
Subscription, sorry. Not a donation because we're not a scheduled
yes.
one.
Yeah.
Whatever it is. Yeah, so that, and you can go like our Facebook page at Soul Shaker City. I always forget what that is. Yeah, that's what it is. So just wanted to mention that before we get going. We appreciate you guys always coming every week. Tom Guzzo is always here, and Luke. And Cheryl's never made it, huh?
No.
Wow, that's kind of crazy.
We got to give her a call, make sure she's okay.
Yeah, we had a little over 200 views on our last one, which is
mad.
Good. And you guys got to understand something. When you see the 200 views, now there's other people that are getting like 1K views and all that. Well, we don't tag everybody on our list. I've got about 600 people I could tag, but I just don't tag them all. But most people tag all their people. We only tag 4 people.
Well, if they're your friends and they're following you, they should see some kind of notification that you're alive, right?
Yeah, yeah. They see the notification.
So they don't need to be tagged.
Yeah, and if you guys ever want to share it, go ahead and share it and let people know we rock and roll and talk. We rock and talk. Is that what we call it? Yeah,
sure.
I guess. I don't like the rhyme stuff, but yeah, there we go.
That's the name for the next show.
Rock and talk?
Rock and talk.
Yeah, and you remember, you guys, now...
Can we do it on a Tuesday? So it could be Rockin' Taco Tuesday.
Rockin' Taco Tuesday. I like that.
We have athletes on Rock, Talk, and Jock.
Walk, Talk, Jock, and Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Wow. That's
so anyway.
Yeah. So anyways.
Moving on.
And again, you know, we always ask if you're a musician, you want to come down and kick back with us, you're more than welcome to. If you're a crowd, you want to come down and eat pizza on our floor while we do the... thing, and you're more than welcome to come on down anytime. We're just email us and or PM us on Facebook, and we'll let you know where the address is. That's the only way we can do it, right?
And instead of a GoFundMe, it's a come on down and fund me.
Come on down and fund me. Yeah,
actual,
so that's
actual personal.
That's how it goes with Soul Shaker Garage here.
$5 at the door. You could be on camera.
No. We're gonna have a tip. Barrel.
Oh, yeah, barrel. Yeah. Not even jar. Wow.
Well, a barrel, yeah.
Well, I had an uncle, a great uncle that was an evangelist, and he'd always try to seed the offering plate, you know, because he'd go from church to church traveling.
Right.
And what he lived off of was those offerings. You know, whenever he was preaching, they'd pass the plate. And he's standing at the back, and they'd, you know, bring the plate up, and it's like full of dollar bills. So he thought, you know, one night I'm gonna put a 10 in there. And so apparently somebody... needed change. It had too many ones, and so they took the 10 out. And anyway.
So that didn't work
for him. He still got ones.
I got
nice.
You. Yeah, so bring us down some ones. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I'm saying that. I don't want
Doug
to start.
Doug will do things for dollar bills.
Dollar bills. He'll do
what is he going to be wearing? What is he going to be wearing?
Whoa, chaps. No.
Speedo.
So what do we have this weekend, kids? What do you got going? Monty's got
Friday night, we're at Bobby V's.
Yeah, you guys want to come down to Bobby V's, you're more than welcome to come and say hello and hang with Dougie and I. We'll be...
I think one of the bands from the Regal is going to be there.
Which one's that? Is it the Hurricanes?
I can't remember. You want me to look while you're talking?
Yeah, go ahead and look. So yeah, we're just we're still cruising. We're doing good. We're getting views. It's so weird where I work, unmentioned again. This week I've had like three or four people say, "Hey, Soul Shaker Garage, we like watching it." So it's kind of cool and Doug and I got noticed by a band member at the Regal Inn. It was funny. He said, "Hey, you guys are in Soul Shaker, right? Soul Shaker Garage, love watching it and all this stuff." So that was kind of cool. So we know it's being seen, and we appreciate it very much. We do it just to hopefully some other local bands will think about doing this, and we won't have to pay to play to get out there. It's so hard to get people to come and see us live, so we do this. Yeah. So it's easy. You sit at home.
But we will be playing live at some point.
Oh, when, Monty? Where at? Are we playing live? When are we playing?
Sometime in the future.
Well, when the stars, when you're off and there's an opening.
I got you. You know my schedule, right?
Yeah, and okay. I figured after the 90 days thing, we'd get serious about it.
Okay.
Yeah, the electric company.
He's a manager. That's an ex-manager talking right there.
The electric company, which is a U2 band. They're playing Cafe Metal. Metal was that one band that...
Metal, the girls.
Yeah.
Okay, got it. Yeah, she was good.
Tony Fontaine and Population U. So there's...
Tony Fontaine?
Five things. Two acoustic sets and three bands.
Nice.
So the two... Well, who's the acoustic? Fontaine and the other guy?
Yeah, I think so.
All right. And so we have a U2 tribute band.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
So come on down. If you guys want to see some U2, come on down to Bobby V's. $5 to get in, if I'm correct.
And the bands will be doing 45-minute sets.
45-minute sets.
Sharp. Start on time.
Sharp.
Well, why don't you guys write up something? Why don't you type up something, Mr. X-Manager? Aren't you good at that? Why don't you type up something that says, you know, because musicians can't read, just make it like three lines and say, get off the stage.
Well, we're doing pretty good with keep your feet off 45. Keep your feet off the monitors. That's working.
He says he's going to do a camp on how to get off and on the stage properly.
That's right. A clinic.
Clinic. I'm sorry. Yeah, it's going to be a clinic.
Instead of...
Sign up for band clinics.
All these band clinics that they have, they just show them how to play. They never show them the etiquette of rock
and roll. I'm going to go to the band camp thing and have a booth on the side saying, if you want to get on and off the stage properly,
how to keep your feet off our monitors.
Keep your drinks off the speakers.
The speakers, and how to not tongue or microphones.
Yeah, and how to assemble your cymbals onto the stands off the stage so that you're ready to go when you get on the stage.
Yeah, the one thing that irritates me is the drummer that gets up there and sets up his drum set on the stage. When we were at the Regal Inn, he got his whole drum set down onto the floor in front of us, and nobody could get up on the stage, and he starts taking stuff apart.
Because he's Neil Peart.
Oh, my gosh. Well,
it's tough in the clubs because you got people
tough
coming in
and
out.
Tough in the clubs, baby. That's the name of my next band, Tough in the Clubs. Are we going to do one more song before we go? What time is it right now? Are we ready to rock?
Let me try and finish thought.
We're at 104.
It's tough in the clubs because there's a small pathway. If you're in an outdoor venue, you can set stuff up ahead of time. And, you know, it's not like bears around running it where if you're not ready to go, you don't go. The next band steps in and they go home early.
Doug will shut you down.
Yeah. Is that the first time you've ever done that?
Shut you down productions?
Yeah.
Well, I would like to see the look on the band's face when you shut them off and start playing Cold Gin. Was it a look that you never want to see?
Oh, they just kind of went like.
They couldn't believe it. Oh, you wanted to know what the mom / manager.
Yeah.
She said, like, 5 minutes. You couldn't give just five more minutes. Just one song, 5 minutes. And I go, the bass player took 5 or 10 minutes to get his rig to work.
All right.
The guitar player broke a string and took maybe 5 minutes to get that done and then tune it.
All right.
You know, this whole thing. And so it's like, no, I'm not going to give you more time because they wasted time.
Yeah.
And the singer, you know, at that point wasn't there either, so... But she's, you know, a little angry about one song. And
clock. There's a running clock.
Do you feel
especially with four
bands? That's what you should have.
Do you feel like you're getting angrier as you get older?
That's what you should have is just a big old clock. And just as soon as first note goes on, 45 minutes.
Yeah, we should have a big digital clock.
No, it should be when I say, because I don't want the drummer going off and getting a beer and standing in line.
Hey, watch out for the drummer.
Okay, the keyboard player, because we don't have one of those.
Okay.
So the keyboard player goes over and gets a beer and standing in line, and it's like, what should you be playing right now? If you should love to play so much that you're ready to go ahead of me being ready to go.
Yeah.
What was the last band we were at, Bobby V's, and he's like, oh, we got one more song? Hold on, I'm gonna go to the restroom. I gotta go to the restroom.
Yeah. Dude, I would have unplugged immediately.
He started unplugging. Doug said that he's like, Monty was here, everything would have been out.
Unplugged, gone.
He's like, that guy would have come out of the bathroom. We would have been gone.
So they got this new TV show on MTV called Unplugged. I'm sure you've heard of it.
Yeah.
But it's not about bands playing with acoustics. It's about this guy done with the set, and the PA is unplugged.
I don't give him a chance.
You don't give anybody a chance.
Give him a chance.
Monty's walking over to the low ends and just unplugging everything right at the end of the song.
And we can't plug it back in because the guy that set it up is gone already.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know where this goes.
Sorry. We did that to the one tribute band at Petroleum with the Wigs.
Yeah.
And they were, he goes, well, then one more. And they did it. As soon as they were done, last chord, they bam, thank you. I went, plut. Yeah. And the guy looked down at me. He goes, oh, I guess we're done. Yeah, you are, brother.
You're overdone, brother.
Yeah. The one thing that just gripes me is they get all set up, and all of a sudden I'm looking for one of the band members. And where are they? They're at the bar getting their booze. I couldn't believe. And then the one guitarist goes to me. He goes, hey, buy me a beer and make sure it's a stout or something. Remember, we were at center field. Oh, and I looked at him. I went, what are you? What? No, what?
You want to say, are you high? But he probably was.
Hey, I couldn't believe it.
Really?
Yeah. He asked me to get him a beer. He's like, hey,
yeah,
come
goes,
here.
Hey, man, hey, go buy me a beer.
He goes, to make sure it's a lager or a stout or whatever.
I would have been.
Oh, my gosh. I was about ready to rip him a new one.
I would have been like, yeah, I'll be right back.
Yeah, I'll be right back. Thank you for your 20.
Appreciate it. Yeah. I'll be right back.
Is there any change? No, I had to use it on a casino. On the way ahead. Do you want to play one more? What's up, Doug? Because you're angry now.
I was born angry.
Born angry.
We're at 108.
Came out going, ah!
We're ready to rock one more and then get out of town.
One more.
We already do Green Man Leash. You better know. You got to sing one. Didn't you sing? You haven't sing one tonight. Are you ready? You want to sing?
No, I don't mind. I'll sing. I don't know.
Mary Had a Little Lamb.
What do you want to sing? Yeah. What do we got? What does he sing? He's already done his original.
Take a load off, Annie.
There you go.
Take a load.
What do you want?
Put the load.
Yeah.
Doug goes, I quit.
I'm hoping that something that this guitar can squeal
bump,
to.
Bump, 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 bump. Let's make him sing a good one because he hasn't sang all night.
What was that you just
said? Rumbling Train, man.
Sing it.
Oh, wow.
Sing it.
Sing it, dude. You sing it good. Stop it. Okay, kids, so we're going to do one more song, and we're going to be out, and we love you guys. I know it's a little late. We're all tired, and it's hot, and we understand it, but thank you for showing up. We love you guys. Thanks. We will be back next. We don't know when.
Have a good night, everybody.
Thank you, Carlos, for being here. Thank you, Doug, Monty, all the rest of them. So at the end of this song, I'm just going to fade us out.
So here's the deal. If you guys go lay your heads down right now, by the time we get done with this song, you'll have a 10-minute launch into going to sleep.
There you go.
Yeah, there you go. So enjoy your evening, you guys. And I got to wake up at 7 a.m. tomorrow. Woo!
I'm about to turn you off.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen. We love you. Keep that holding that note. We are Soul Shaker. Good night, Charlie Brown. We love you guys. Take care. Keep holding that note. There was nothing at the end. What the heck?
I was off already.
That was good.
What the heck? All right, kids. Take it easy. Adios. We'll see you next week.
My 45 minutes was up. I am off the stage.